Guys, big news coming in. The federal government in Canada has indicated that they have big plans in place to ease the travel restrictions around COVID-19. They are very well in a good shape to end the infamous the 3-day hotel quarantine and the 14-day quarantine period. There are a lot of updates around those particular requirements and also the people who are coming into Canada. Please watch this video till the end. My name is Sahil and I am going to discuss this particular quarantine, the vaccines and all of these requirements, the upcoming changes next month with regards to Canadian travel. Please be tuned. Alright guys, so welcome back once again. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant and I practice in Brampton, Ontario. My office is there, but right now I'm traveling to India. So if you have to get in touch with me, please drop a message on WhatsApp on my Canadian number and you could give me a regular call on the Indian number while I'm traveling to India. Guys, before we start, if you're watching this video, if you're watching me for the first time, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button, the like button and also the bell icon, because we talk a lot about Canadian immigration. If you are an aspirant, then this is the channel that you must be watching. Alright guys, so what I have for you today is a very important piece of information that the federal government of Canada has finally decided upon. Ending this particular quarantine, the hotel quarantine period, and also they have decided to end the travel restriction related miseries that have been plaguing all the tourists who have been trying to reach Canada. But like Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said, this entire journey is going to be on a phased out approach. Canada, I mean, a very short time after the Prime Minister announced, the health minister Patty Hajdu, she came out and then she announced that this first step in the phased out approach starts with easing the federal government's pandemic border measures on this announcement happened on Wednesday, and they said that the first step is basically allowing fully vaccinated Canadians who will be allowed to travel outside Canada, and then when they return, they will not have to isolate or rather stay in a hotel quarantine if, like I said, fully vaccinated, if they are fully vaccinated. Now, what are the details around that full vaccination? First, that you need to know, and then we'll talk about who are eligible to travel. So at the moment, Canada is recognizing only 4 types of vaccines. The first one is Pfizer, BioNTech. The second is Moderna, third is AstraZeneca, and fourth is Johnson & Johnson. Now, what the government has to say is that if you have completed the due dosage prescribed with regards to each of these medicines, that means you are completely vaccinated, you are fully vaccinated, which says if any particular medicine prescribes 2 shots, take both the shots. If any medicine or any vaccine prescribes 1 shot, take that, and you should be fully vaccinated. And such dosage or delivery must be recognized by Canada itself. So that takes care of the first part, that you're fully vaccinated. Second part says you should ensure that this vaccination is completed at least 14 days prior to your arrival in Canada. Okay. Now third part says only eligible travelers who have been fully vaccinated will be allowed to enter Canada. And they might not have to undergo, or they will not have to undergo, the hotel quarantine measures in place. When they reach Canada, they will have to show the negative RT-PCR test for sure, and they will have to take a test on the border again. Now they will have to self-isolate until the test results come of the test that they took at the border again. Now that could take 24 hours, 48 hours, 72 hours, whatever, but until and unless that those test results come out, you will have to self-isolate wherever you are living, and once the tests are negative, you can very well go around in Canada. You will not have to get into quarantine again. So this was the announcement. The federal government has also announced that they are planning to release it in early July. We don't have a specific date as of yet, so early July is when they are planning to release. We are still awaiting more details and clarity on what is the category of people who will be allowed to travel. For now, at least we know that Canadians and permanent residents fall into this eligibility. We will very soon be knowing whether students एंड फैमिली मेंबर्स ऑफ पीआर एंड कैनेडियन सिटीजंस आर अलाउड और नॉट. The minister said, and the you know the lead doctor said that they will be finalizing those details and the information will be out pretty soon. Now, with regards to vaccine passports, there was a short, crisp update that the federal government is still discussing the vaccine passports, the delivery, and the recognition of those certificates with the provincial governments. The talks are still ongoing. The the app, that the Arrive Can app, will play an important role in ensuring that who is vaccinated, who is not. They might have this particular portal up soon, or they will have the delivery guidelines. We are still yet to see how are people going to prove whether they have been fully vaccinated or not, who is eligible to travel exactly. Those pieces of information, those missing pieces or puzzles of information, are due to come in pretty soon. But for now, guys, I think this is a very good news. What at least you know is that travelers from India and abroad, if your country has AstraZeneca, Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson's available, take the full course as prescribed by the vaccine maker and the Canadian government, whatever is recognized. And, you know, take this ASAP, and as soon as the guidelines are up out in the public, you can start planning your travel accordingly to Canada. Guys, I hope the information was pleasing and gave you some ray of hope for all those who are planning to travel. Once we have more updates, we will definitely come out with another video and we will keep you posted. Until then, I would like to let you know, if you have more questions, feel free to drop in a message on WhatsApp and schedule a consultation if you need to speak to me for more information. And also, I wish you all the best, and I really hope to see you soon in Canada.